niggas, why I nipped out, bro. Like, he a nigga that actually, like, you know, he been in it, but Cuz was building. He was building his enemies and everybody, bro.
Right.
Yeah, man, I know, like, you fucked with him. Niggas don't even know how much you fucked with him like that. Like, for real, bro. Like, man, out of all the ones to get, man.
Yeah, that's a bad stain on the West Coast right now, man.
Man, heavy, heavy.
That's a bad stain on L.A., man.
Man, it's a bad stain, man. That nigga stopped, man. You know how many times that nigga Nip stopped, bro? My mama died. That nigga Nip stopped his interview in the middle of his interview for about an hour, bro. Fuck all the bullshit. You all right? Man, you know my daughter. You know how my daughter is, you know?
Right, right.
You know how many times Nip and grabbed my daughter and told my daughter some real shit? Like, hold up, what did you do? Your people's just somebody's out here.
Right.
Oh, this shit hurt, bro.
I know, I had shit that night, man. Because all I just kept thinking about was when we first met. You know how we clicked up, because you know Ving introduced us.
Yeah.
You know Ving called.
I know you was on that fly crippin'.
Yo, he searched, Ving searched, and it's crazy because Ving searched me out and found me just like he searched Nipsey out. Seen us talking on some type of internet. On some type of DVD, and was like, yo, these some hood niggas, but these really some smart ass hood niggas.
Yeah.
Call me up, yo, man. I like the way you think, man. I want you think you can act. I want to put you in a movie. Then call me up back and say, yo, you ever heard of Nipsey Hussle? I'm like, no. He like, he a nigga from the West Coast, man. He kind of remind me of a younger version of you, the way he talk, the way he think. I want to put y'all in the movie, man. I want y'all to play opposite roles of each other.
The brothers.
I come down. He introduced me to Nip. It was me and Nip sat out there in front of the prison and chopped it up for about 4 hours on set every day.
Man, this one
right hurt. Then we've been brothers ever since, man.
This one hurt right here, Kill. Everything, man. And then, like, the cold part, this be like the thing, like, niggas still be giving back, man, and look what happened when you right there sometimes, bro.
Right. That's like, honestly, man, that's like, that's crazy, man. It's good, because, dog, 10 out of 10 niggas get that money and get the fuck away from niggas, man. That's 10 out of 10 niggas, man.
Man, when you coming back, you
just be for real. Let's just be for real. What motherfucking artists be opening up stores and shit in they hoods? I'll wait.
Not a lot.
I'll wait.
Not a lot.
Because niggas can't do it. PNB Rock tried to do that shit. I don't know if it was PNB Rock, but his team tried to do that shit. Niggas started shooting outside of his shit. It's like every time you try to do something in the hood, in your own neighborhood, you try to bring shit back. You look at Saul.
Saul
trying to open up a motherfucking store in her neighborhood. Niggas break into her shit. She don't sell shit but food. What the fuck is y'all breaking in her shit for? To steal some fucking collard greens, you fucking dickheads.
Hey, man, I ain't gonna hold you. I get rich, I'm gone. That was it. That was the straw that broke the camel's back right there. Nip was a good nigga. I ain't nearly as a good nigga as Nip. I'm out.
Oh, bitch, you definitely ain't half a good nigga as Nip.
Nip was a good nigga. Nip was a good nigga. He was a good
you
nigga.
You don't add up to half, nigga. You like 40% a good nigga. Sure, with me a couple niggas on here, he might have deserved it.
Yeah, you ain't shit. Me. That is like, hey,
we talking about this, nigga. You ain't shit.
No, he is a good nigga, though. He's a good one, bro. I ain't gonna take that from him.
For real.
Yeah, I'm gonna get back to your shit, man. I know you coming in, but cut down, man. I'm about to go to Vegas real fast for the Gunna tour. Yeah. Nigga on tour, yeah, but I don't know this shit. I ain't gonna hold you last night, like a little funny, like whole little night.
Is your brother cool?
Man, they
everybody over there cool.
No. I mean, is his brother? I heard his brother got hit too.
I don't know if that was his brother because I was on tour. I was at another show. I got a phone call and just kind of was like, "What the fuck just happened?"
Hey, somebody told me his brother was in a coma. Somebody called me from LA last night and told me his brother was in a coma. I don't know.
I still don't know who the other two people was who got shot.
Yeah.
I still don't know who the other two people was, but I know that was. I know you was close, so man, I know you feeling it, bro. That man.
You know, hey, you know who called me and you know who texted me and told me.
Ving. Sam. Oh man.
Ving Rhames, man. I was eating dinner last night and Butcher and Singer with my wife, my man Toy and his wife, because my man just turned 40 and shit. So you know, I was like, man, let's go get some dinner, man. Celebrate, man. 40. You know what I mean? And Ving texted me and said Nipsey just got shot. I was like, what?
You know, I was grabbing some weed and then we going to the house of Blue Anaheim. And somebody said, nigga, you know they got Nip. I was goddamn near passed out. And they said it was real, damn near, oh my God. Like I say, out of all the niggas, I did not wake up or think, nigga, you was gonna hear Nip, don't be on that. He involved out of that. But man, go and get back to the show, man. Your people gonna wanna holler at you. This is very, it's a hard hit, man.
It's hard. You already know how late.
I'll be down there. I'll probably come down there before you come down here.
Absolutely. All right, hit me, Cat.
All right, no more.
Click off and click back on. This shit ain't letting me call nobody.